I have theorized that part of my openness to a more progressive left politics is because I grew up witnessing a version of what the world could be that was post-scarcity. There's no more money. They have a kind of a system based on exploration and science, and people don't have to work to survive. And it has, the theory goes, made me more open to a certain kind of political agenda that is perceived as largely impossible, or that people can't seem to necessarily wrap their mind around in the mainstream. So in the course of making that argument on one of our early episodes, Wyatt complicated the notion that a Star Trek utopia is something that we should be aiming for in the first instance.
I was just suggesting that, you know, they're kind of the space navy, and this socialist utopia is one that is, it's being maintained by a militaristic hand, a heavy militaristic hand. And so that's all I was saying, was that, you know, this exploration, it's exploration that's being done as a military mission, I don't know how diplomatic it is when the main thing is like, come join our federation. But if you don't, good luck out there. Come join the space navy.
So you think it's the federation is by design coercive, or by in effect coercive?
I don't know how coercive it is. I mean, I feel like in the original series, it's definitely... Kirk is not, doesn't seem to be the most, like, diplomatic guy. He seems to get into his fair share of fights. Or his version of diplomacy is, let me sleep with Space Princess. And now we've got a contract.
I largely, and this might be unfair term drawing, I don't think of the original series when I'm talking about Space Utopia. Because obviously... Space Utopia. Because
Space
the original.
God damn it.
The original series was advanced for its time, but nobody could pretend that it doesn't have its flaws. I mean,
yes.
I'm not going to defend the use of miniskirts, although I could, because there were some men in miniskirts in Next Generation in background scenes, because it's a thoughtful show.
Yeah.
Josh, I would. Josh, I want to bring you in here because you heard our discourse, and I heard you later come to my defense on your podcast when you had Virgil on, and you asked him why he didn't fight for my valor harder and during that episode.
Well, yeah, and Dave Anthony too, who is here, who's my host, my co-host, right, on West Wing thing. I've abused both of them for not standing up for you. And Dave's flimsy excuse is it was funny, which he's a comedian, and they seem to think that's all that matters. But
I was attacking nobody. I was just, this was a version of diplomacy.
Hey, people are saying, I'm not, it's, but I have to say, I will say this, the more I, and then when you said you were going to do this episode and I'd have my chance to step into the arena, like a Gorn with Wyatt, somebody must get that joke. I went back and watched a whole bunch from a bunch of the different series, and he's right, but he's wrong. He's okay. Right, but he's wrong. It is a space navy. it's the thing that really hit me watching it, and there are real world reasons for this, because obviously there are different writers, and it is a fictional universe. I know that's something we're not supposed to talk about, but Star Trek isn't utopian. It is many steps closer to utopia than we are now.
Sure.
And because I did start finding myself very uncomfortable with the space navy aspect of it. and the fact that, yeah, when he's not hopping into bed with alien babes, Kirk is basically interfering in little internecine battles between people and, you know, basically throwing him into a room and going, punch it out like men, which does not strike me as the most enlightened
one. Yeah, he's always brawling in every clip I've seen.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Like just wrestling with a burly alien, like a teamster in an alien outfit.
Yeah, but you know what's interesting is, as someone who's a fan, I mean, I caught him in reruns as a kid. I'm not that old, but as someone who's a huge fan of the original show, I first rejected Next Generation, and one of the things that bothered me about it was the fact that Picard doesn't get into fights, and the fact that I think literally the first episode, you know, he's going to beam down to the planet, and his first in command goes, "You can't go down there. You're the fucking captain. That's insane."
Right.
And over time, as I got immersed into it, the next show actually started to address the failings of the first show and the absurdities yes. of it. But they were advancing.
Yes.
Sure. Right? They were using de-escalation tactics as opposed to just, you know, taking somebody into the interrogation room and hitting them with a phone book. Picard is the cop who, you know, he sees where the wind is blowing and he's like, let's go into de-escalation. We'll do some unconscious bias training, although it's really still not going to help us when it comes to Worf, because we're still going to be like, hey, we got a Klingon, and be a little racist to him. But yeah, he's the sheriff in like a progressive college town.